Good evening, everyone. Tina Spalding, Trans Channel, here today for day 38 of 40 days and 40 nights with Jesus. And this is our evening session. Let's see what Jesus has to say to us this evening. You are blessed beings indeed. I am that one that you know as Jesus. And as you wind down today, it is important to give yourself credit for everything that you have done so far in our 40 days and 40 nights together. These are challenging times, and we are challenging you further by asking you to look inside your hearts and minds to figure out what makes you tick. But it is a long job to figure out what makes you tick. Most of you have tens of thousands of beliefs and ideas and principles that you have been taught. You have all been through a tremendous training program, several training programs, in fact. Your cultural training program, whatever country you're living in, your family training program, your religious training program, your educational training program, the values of the TV shows that you watch, which may be different than your culture, for example. Your financial training programs, so many, and within each of those programs, there are a multiplicity of beliefs and ideas and principles that you have been taught over time. So when you are studying A Course in Miracles or any spiritual practice, do not get frustrated with yourself because you find yourself going back to old habits. We want you to understand that those old habits have been put into you time and time and time again. If you have habits that you would like to break, you can use the 40 days and 40 nights to specifically focus on a habit that you have, or a belief, a value system that you have that you see no longer works for you, but is still dogging you, is still showing up time and time again. You can begin the 40 days and nights with a prayer of focus and intention to shift and change one particular habit. Now, some of you will say, why didn't you tell us that at the beginning? Well, we wanted you to go through the 40 days and 40 nights openly without having any kind of agenda. The 40 days and nights gives you a sort of general tune-up of your frequency, a general tune-up of awareness, if you will. But if you have a specific issue that you want to deal with, you can go through the 40 days and nights. Again, we say do it as a 40-day practice, not 20-day practice. Don't shove them all in there together. Do it as a proper 40-day practice with your intention of giving up that bad habit at each lesson and with each practice that you are doing. So for example, when we have set you assignments, bring the habit up that you are particularly interested in breaking or relinquishing, and focus the lesson around that habit. Let's say you have some eating disorders or eating issues. When we talk to you about what you value, you can talk about the foods that you value, or the events around which foods are eaten, Christmas, for example, or Thanksgiving. You can write down, oh, I really value family food time. I feel really bad if I can't have Thanksgiving with my family. That's a belief that you hold that is not a universal belief. Other people in other cultures don't have that belief. And as soon as you bring that up, you realize, oh, people in North America have that belief because they have been programmed to have that belief. People in Brazil may not have that belief. That means it's optional. That means it's optional for you. So that's what we want to bring to mind to you, to your mind this evening, is this idea that you can use the 40 days and 40 nights as a therapy to help you focus and heal one particular part of your life. I am that one that you know as Jesus, and I'll speak to you again tomorrow. Thanks for joining me this evening. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.